Thank you, Prime Minister, and thank you, Prime Minister Soljus, Marius, Lewis. This is a wonderful opportunity to make a historic beginning. This is the first visit of an Israeli Prime Minister to the Baltic states, to Lithuania. It is deep with meaning, both in a historical sense, the experience of the Jewish people, the community that had been here, was destroyed, was reconstituted really in the Jewish state, which now comes here to the reconstituted democracies of the Baltic group. We're all small democracies, but with giant spirits of our people, committed to freedom, committed to liberty, committed to seizing the future, and I think we can seize it better together. I am delighted that the Prime Ministers have accepted my invitation to have the next or a future B3 meeting in Jerusalem. We want to enhance it with a meeting of Baltic business and technological people and scientists, because I think this is where our future is. We discussed two big areas. The first is the area of innovation. The future belongs to those who innovate. They are tremendous intellectual powers in Israel, in Estonia, in Latvia, in in Lithuania. And if we pool them together for certain projects, and we have some ideas, clear ideas in mind, then we can make our people advance at a much greater pace and to be at the cutting edge of certain industries, even new industries that people have not realized. I give one example. Is cyber. You can give other examples here, whether it's lasers or e-government, where there is a tremendous advancement here that I, and in other areas that I've admired in the Baltic region. We can be at the forefront. The fact that we are small doesn't mean that we can't be big. If we focus our energies in the technologies of the future and we harness the talents of our people, we can be very big. I think this is the first area. The second area is security. We are already cooperating in a number of security and defense-related areas. And here, too, I think that we can do a great deal more. We discussed this in some detail, and I believe that more can be done. I unabashedly asked the help of my friends here in making correcting what I think is a distorted position, a distorted view on Israel in the EU. I don't mean the EU countries. We are doing that on our own with all the countries of Europe, the large and small. I'm talking about the organization as such. We discussed a number of ways that we can advance better agreement. One of the areas that I think is not fully understood is Iran. The nuclear deal with Iran threatened Europe as well, because it didn't really stop the race to a nuclear weapon. In fact, it enabled Iran to pursue the enrichment of uranium unlimited within a few years. What would open the path not to a nuclear bomb, but an entire nuclear arsenal. But at the same time, it also brought to Iran's coffers billions and billions of dollars that were used for the purposes of oppressing their own people inside Iran, who suffer under that tyranny, and of course seeking to expand the conquest of the Middle East to Iran, in Iraq, in Syria, in Yemen, in Lebanon, so many other places. I think that the decision yesterday by the EU to give 18 million euros to Iran is a big mistake. It's like a poison pill to the Iranian people and to the efforts to curb Iranian aggression in the region and terror beyond the region. Iran tried to conduct a terror attack on the soil of Europe just a few weeks ago, while Iran's foreign minister was leading with European leaders. That is incredible. And I think giving money to this regime at this time is a big mistake and should be stopped. Where will the extra money go? It's not going to go to solve the water problem in Iran. It's not going to go for Iranian truck drivers. It's going to go to the missiles and the Revolutionary Guards in Iran, in Syria, and elsewhere in the Middle East. I think this should be changed. All countries should join the efforts to restore sanctions on Iran in order to press them to stop their aggression and desist on their terrorist activities. We have had, not only a meeting of the minds, but also a meeting of the hearts. There was the tragedy that befell the Jews here was one that resonates for our people and resonates for me personally. My family came from Lithuania over a century ago to what is now Israel. But there is not a person among us who does not know the depth of that tragedy. And the fact that the governments here have taken a strong position, both in restoring Jewish sites and also in fighting anti-Semitism so unequivocally, so clearly, is something that we appreciate deeply, and it's also part of this growing friendship between us. So from every respect, I think this has been a very, very successful meeting, and I hope to continue it, as we say, next year in Jerusalem. Thank you.
Dėkoju. Dabar paprašysiu Estijos premjero.